So what's this you're making? Nasi kunyit. Oh, tomorrow. Today's June, July 2015. So this is a bag of glutinous rice. How many grams?
500.
500 grams, and you put it inside this.
Wash the rice.
Wash the rice.
Until it runs clear. The water runs clear, and then you put in 1.5 tablespoons of kunyit powder.
Kunyit powder. What's kunyit powder?
This powder.
Okay, kunyit powder.
And asam keping.
See one of those.
Steep it in water.
Asam keping. Okay, what's the next process?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, you're going to leave it overnight?
Yeah, leave it overnight, soak. It will turn yellow, is it?
Right, you just want the rice to turn yellow. Okay.
Very good. The classic, the kunyit, this
is. So only 4 ingredients, asam, kunyit powder, glutinous rice, and water. Okay. This is what the pot of glutinous rice with kunyit looks like after one night. You see the asam there? Pieces of asam.
The rice has become yellow.
Okay. So now you're removing the pieces of asam out. Why don't you cook it with the rice? Don't cook. I see you have 2 pieces of banana leaf. What are you doing now? You're cooking the banana leaf.
Making it soft.
By putting it over the fire.
Yes.
Where do you learn this from?
By watching elderly people do it.
Or by softening it, they won't tear easily. On both sides, sir.
One side will do.
So clean the.
Wipe the leaf clean.
Have the leaf clean and cut it into small pieces, like so. So now you're layering the banana leaf in a pot, steaming pot. The last time you used that weaving basket, not using that anymore. The rattan.
I thought we used this one. Yeah. This is more steady. I can use the big wok. The whole rice go in.
Now you're collecting pandan leaves. White pepper.
Peppercorns.
Peppercorns.
They put into the rice.
Wash the peppercorn in water. Actually, I don't like the peppercorns. Normally in the hawker centers, they don't put
They're not Nyonya style.
Chinese style.
Nyonya style lah.
Cutting the pandan in half. For the santan. Only use a quarter of it.
Thin it.
Oh, that's a lot of water. The water will flow through the banana leaves. Mm. That means it's not much lah, the santan that you use for coconut milk.
Later you have to use thick one.
Shouldn't you be putting it over the steaming water?
No.
Now?
Then the rice won't get it, is it?
No, wouldn't the coconut milk
flow
through the banana leaves?
Hope not.
Fully close the thing.
Yeah. Steam it.
How long will you steam it for?
20 minutes.
20 minutes.
On high heat.
So this after 20 minutes, huh? Mm-hmm. You can see the steam coming out. Mm-hmm. And this place is not cold, not in winter. No winter in Malaysia. What are you doing now?
All the thick santan that has salt in it.
Thick santan plus salt in it.
Drizzle over this.
The rice is already cooked, right? Glutinous rice.
It's not totally cooked yet.
Please semi cooked. So So you're putting the thick coconut. Previously it was the diluted coconut water. Now it's the just slightly, thick coconut with a bit of water. Mix it in. A bit of salt. Did any of the santan or coconut milk drip into the water? Not much, the water is still clear. We're putting back in the kunyit after mixing it properly. How long?
Now 15 minutes.
15 minutes to steam. The rice is ready.
Ready, I think.
Potato. Now I have to separate the
powder.
The pandan leaf from the rice. Can throw away the pandan leaves already. Why don't you just leave the rice in this pot here? Why must you transfer it to fresh pandan leaf, banana leaves?
Easier to keep on with the lid there.
Oh, okay. So you were saying that instead of a rice cooker pot, they put it inside
a pot.
A long time ago, the Baba Yongyas, they put it in an earthen pot.
So it's cool and keep longer.
Cool and keep longer. Do you know the reason why? Why it will keep longer? Even without the use of refrigerators or temperature control?
It's the pot lah. It's the modern pot. Right.
Yes, so. So that's how you make nasi kunyit.